This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. British Railways Bridge, which from 1965 traded as British Rail, was the operator of most of the rail transport in Great Britain between 1948 and 1997. It was formed from the nationalisation of the Big Four British Railway Companies and lasted until the gradual privatisation of British Rail, in stages between 1994 and 1997. Originally a trading brand of the Railway Executive of the British Transport Commission, it became an independent statutory corporation in 1962. The British Railways Board. The period of nationalisation saw sweeping changes in the national railway network. A process of dieselisation and electrification took place, and in 1968 steam locomotion had been entirely replaced by diesel and electric traction, except for one narrow gauge tourist line. Passengers replaced freight as the main source of business, and one-third of the network was closed by the Beeching Axe of the 1960s in an effort to reduce rail subsidies on privatisation. Responsibility for track, signalling and stations was transferred to Railtrack, which was later brought under public control as Network Rail, and that for trains to the train operating companies. The British Rail double arrow logo is formed of two interlocked arrows showing the direction of travel on a double track railway and was nicknamed the Arrow of Indecision. It is now employed as a generic symbol on street signs in Great Britain denoting railway stations, and as part of the Association of Train Operating Companies ATOC jointly managed. National Rail brand is still being printed on railway tickets. Contents 1 History 11 Nationalisation in 1948-111 Regions 12 1955 Modernisation Plan 13 The Beeching Report 14 Post-Beeching 2 Branding 3 Finances 31 Investment 32 Privatisation 4 Accidents and Incidents 5 Network 6 Preserved Railway Lines 7 Marine Services 71 Ships 72 Hovercraft 8 Advanced Passenger Train 9 Successor Companies 10 Future 11 Parodies 12 See also 13 References 14 Further Reading 15 External Links History Main Article, History of Rail Transport in Great Britain 1948-1994 Rail Passengers in Great Britain from 1829-2014 Nationalisation in 1948 BR Steam Locomotive, No. 70013 Oliver Cromwell as Bridge Modernised, Diesel and Electric Locomotion Gradually Replaced steam pictured, 2 preserved warship class diesel hydraulics. The rail transport system in Great Britain developed during the 19th century after the grouping of 1923 under the Railways Act 1921. There were 4 large railway companies, each dominating its own geographic area: the Great Western Railway GWR, the London, Midland and Scottish Railway LMS, the London and North Eastern Railway LNER and the Southern Railway Senior. During World War I the railways were under state control, which continued until 1921. Complete nationalisation had been considered, and the Railways Act 1921 is sometimes considered as a precursor to that, but the concept was rejected. Nationalisation was subsequently carried out after World War II, under the Transport Act 1947. This act made provision for the nationalisation of the network, as part of a policy of nationalising public services by Clement Attlee's Labour government. British Railways came into existence as the business name of the Railway Executive of the British Transport Commission BTC on 1 January 1948 when it took over the assets of the Big Four. There were also joint railways between the Big Four and a few light railways to consider. See list of constituents of British Railways excluded from nationalisation were industrial lines like the Oxfordshire Ironstone Railway. The London Underground, publicly owned since 1933, was also nationalised, becoming the London Transport Executive of the British Transport Commission. The Bicester Military Railway was already run by the government. The Electric Liverpool Overhead Railway was also excluded from nationalisation. The Railway Executive was conscious that some lines on the then very dense network were unprofitable and hard to justify socially, and a programme of closures began almost immediately after nationalisation. However, the general financial position of BR became gradually poorer. Until an operating loss was recorded in 1955, the executive itself had been abolished in 1953 by the Conservative government, and control of BR transferred directly to the parent commission. Other changes to the British Transport Commission at the same time included the return of road haulage to the private sector. Regions. British Railways was divided into regions initially based on the areas the former Big Four operated in, however, several lines were transferred between regions over the years. Notably, this included the former Great Great Central Lines from the Eastern Region to the London Midland Region, and the West of England Main Line from the Southern Region to Western Region. Southern Region of British Railways, former Southern Railway Lines. Western Region of British Railways, former Great Western Railway Lines. London Midland Region of British Railways, former London Midland and Scottish Railway Lines in England. Eastern Region of British Railways, former London and North Eastern Railway Lines. South of York. North Eastern Region of British Railways, former London and North Eastern Railway Lines in England. North of York. Scottish Region of British Railways. All lines, regardless of original company, in Scotland. The North Eastern Region was merged with the Eastern Region in 1967. In the 1980s, the regions were abolished and replaced by business sectors, a process known as sectorisation. The Anglia region was created in late 1987, its first general manager being John Edmonds, who began his appointment on the 19th of October 1987. Full separation from the Eastern Region, apart from engineering design needs, occurred on the 29th of April 1988. It handled the services from Fenchurch Street and Liverpool Street, its western boundary being Hertford East, Meldrith, and Whittlesea. 1955 Modernisation Plan. See also 1955 Modernisation Plan. The report, latterly known as the Modernisation Plan, was published in January 1955. It was intended to bring the railway system into the 20th century. A government white paper produced in 1956 stated that modernisation would help eliminate BR's financial deficit by 1962, but the figures in both this and the original plan were produced for political reasons and not based on detailed analysis. The aim was to increase speed, reliability, safety, and line capacity through a series of measures that would make services more attractive to passengers and freight operators, thus recovering traffic lost to the roads. Important areas included electrification of principal main lines in the Eastern Region, Kent, Birmingham, Liverpool, Manchester and Central Scotland. Large-scale dieselisation to replace steam locomotives. New passenger and freight rolling stock. Resignalling and track renewals. Modern marshalling yards. The closure of an unspecified, but relatively small, number of lines. The government appeared to endorse the 1955 programme, costing £12. The Beeching Report Network for Development proposed in 1965 report the development of the major trunk routes bold lines during the late 1950s. Railway finances continued to worsen, whilst passenger numbers grew after restoring many services reduced during the war, and in 1959 the government stepped in, limiting the amount the BTC could spend without ministerial authority. A white paper proposing reorganisation was published in the following year, and a new structure was brought into effect by the Transport Act 1962. This abolished the commission and replaced it by several separate boards. These included a British Railways Board, which took over on 1 January 1963, citation needed, a Scammel Scarab truck in British Railways livery, London, 1962. British Railways was involved in numerous related businesses, including road haulage. Following semi-secret discussions on railway finances by the government appointed Stedeford Committee in 1961, one of its members, Dr. Richard Beeching, was offered the post of chairing the BTC while it lasted, and then becoming the first chairman of the British Railways Board. A major traffic census in April 1961, which lasted 1 week, was used in the compilation of a report on the future of the network. This report, The Reshaping of British Railways, was published by the BRB in March 1963. The proposals, which became known as the Beeching Axe, were dramatic. A third of all passenger services and more than 4,000 of the 7,000 stations would close. Beeching, who is thought to have been the author of most of the report, set out some dire figures. One third of the network was carrying just 1% of the traffic of the 18,000 passenger coaches. 6,000 were said to be used only 18 times a year or less, although maintaining them cost between £3 million and £4 million a year. They earned only about £0.05 million. Most of the closures were carried out between 1963 and 1970, including some which were not listed in the report. While other suggested closures were not carried out, the closures were heavily criticized at the time, and continue to be controversial. A small number of stations and lines closed under the Beeching program have been reopened, with further reopenings proposed. A second Beeching report, The Development of the Major Trunk Routes, followed in 1965. This did not recommend closures as such, but outlined a network for development. The fate of the rest of the network was not discussed in the report. Post-Beeching, the basis for calculating passenger fares changed in 1964. In future, fares on some routes, such as rural, holiday and commuter services, would be set at a higher level than on other routes. Previously, fares had been calculated using a simple rate for the distance. traveled, which at the time was 3D per mile second class, and 4.5D per mile first class equivalent to £023 and £034 respectively. In 2015, passenger levels decreased steadily from 1962 to the late 1970s, but experienced a renaissance with the introduction of the high-speed intercity 125 trains in the late 1970s and early 1980s, and the accompanying Age of the Train advertising campaign. Network improvements included completing electrification of the Great Eastern Main Line from London to Norwich between 1976 and 1986 and the East Coast Main Line from London to Edinburgh between 1985 and 1990. A main line route closure during this period of relative network stability was the 1,500 volts DC electrified Woodhead Line between Manchester and Sheffield. Passenger service ceased in 1970 and goods in 1981. The 1980s and 1990s saw the closure of some railways which had survived the Beeching Axe a generation earlier, but which had seen passenger services withdrawn. This included the bulk of the Chester and Connah's Quay Railway in 1992, the Brierley Hill to Walsall section of the South Staffordshire Line in 1993, while the Birmingham to Wolverhampton section of the Great Western Railway was closed in three phases between 1972 and 1992. A further British Rail report, from a committee chaired by Sir David Serple, was published in 1983. The Serple report made no recommendations as such, but it set out various options for the network, including, at their most extreme, a skeletal system of less than 2,000 route km. This report was not welcomed, and the government decided to quietly leave it on the shelf. Meanwhile, BR was gradually reorganized, with the regional structure finally being abolished and replaced with business-led sectors. This process, known as sectorization, led to far greater customer focus, but was cut short in 1994 with the splitting up of BR for privatisation Network South East, with a networker at Charing Cross serving Kent. Upon sectorization in 1982, three passenger sectors were created: intercity, operating principal express services, London rose by 262%, but RPI only increased by 154% in the same time. Branding. Main article: British Rail corporate liveries. Rail blue colours, class 40-40128, with blue and grey coaching at Llandudno in 1982. Following nationalisation in 1948, British Railways began to adapt the corporate liveries on the rolling stock it had inherited from its predecessor railway companies. Initially, a GWR-style Brunswick green was used on passenger locomotives, and LNWR-style lined black for mixed-traffic locomotives, but later green was more widely adopted. Development of a corporate identity for the organisation was hampered by the competing ambitions of the British Transport Commission and the Railway Executive. The Executive attempted to introduce a modern, curved logo which could also serve as the standard for station signage totems due to its similarity to a hot dog. It became known as the Flying Sausage. BR eventually adopted the common branding of the BTC as its first corporate logo, an Art Deco style motif of a lion astride a spoked wheel, designed for the BTC by Cecil Thomas. On the bar overlaid across the wheel, the BTC's name was replaced with the words British Railways. This logo, nicknamed the Cycling Lion, was applied from 1948 to 1956 to the sides of locomotives, while the sausage logo was adopted for station signs across Great Britain, each coloured according to the appropriate BR region. In 1956, the BTC was granted a heraldic achievement by the College of Arms and the Lord Lyon, and then BTC chairman Brian Robertson wanted a grander logo for the railways. BR's second corporate logo, 1956-1965, designed in consultation with Charles Franklin, adapted the original, depicting a rampant lion emerging from a heraldic crown and holding a spoked wheel, all enclosed in a roundel with the British Railways name displayed across a bar on either side. This emblem soon acquired the nickname of the Ferret and Dartboard. A variant of the logo with the name in a circle was also used on locomotives. The zeal for modernization in the Beeching era drove the next rebranding exercise, and BR management wished to divest the organization of anachronistic, heraldic motifs and develop a corporate identity to rival that of London Transport. BR's design panel set up a working party led by Milner Gray of the Design Research Unit. They drew up a corporate identity manual which established a coherent brand and design standard for the whole organization, specifying rail blue and pearl gray as the standard color scheme for all rolling stock, rail alphabet as the standard corporate typeface, designed by Jacques Kinnaire and Margaret Calvert, and introducing the now iconic corporate identity symbol of the double arrow logo designed by Gerald Barney, also of the Drew. This arrow device was formed of two interlocked arrows across two parallel lines, symbolizing a double-track railway. It was likened to a bolt of lightning or barbed wire, and also acquired a nickname, the arrow of indecision. A mirror image of the double arrow was used. On the port side of BR-owned sea-link ferry funnels, the new BR corporate identity and double arrow were rolled out in 1965, and the brand name of the organization was truncated to British Rail. The uniformity of BR branding continued until the process of sectorization was introduced in the 1980s. Certain bridge operations such as Intercity, Network Southeast or Rail Freight began to adopt their own identities, introducing logos and color schemes which were essentially variants of the British Rail brand. Eventually, as sectorization developed into a prelude to privatization, the unified British Rail brand disappeared, with the notable exception of the double arrow symbol, which has survived to this day and serves as a generic trademark to denote railway services across Great Britain. The Bridge Corporate Identity Manual is noted as a piece of British design history, and there are plans for it to be republished. The first emblem of British Railways, the Cycling Lion, 1950-1956 Liverpool Central Station sign using the Flying Sausage format, the ferret. Despite its nationalisation in 1947 as one of the commanding heights of the economy, according to some sources, British Rail was not profitable for most, if not all, of its history. Newspapers reported that as recently as the 1990s, public rail subsidy was counted as profit. As early as 1961, British Railways were losing £300,000 a day. It was thought that most of the nationalised railways, excluding some freight services, would cease to operate like other unprofitable privatised businesses in the UK, and British Rail's profitability was questioned. Although the company was considered the sole public transport option in many rural areas, the beaching cuts made buses the only public transport available in some rural areas, despite increases in traffic congestion and automotive fuel prices beginning to rise in the 1990s. British Rail remained unprofitable following sectorisation. Intercity became profitable. This sector became the first long-distance passenger railway in the UK to go into profit. Intercity became one of Britain's top 150 companies, with civilised city centre to city centre travel across the nation from Aberdeen and Inverness in the north to Poole and Penzance in the south. Investment. This section is incomplete. February 2013. In 1988, the line to Aberdare was reopened. A British Rail advertisement, Britain's Railway, directed by Hugh Hudson, featured some of the most iconic railway structures in Britain, including the Fourth Rail Bridge, Royal Albert Bridge, Glenfinnan Viaduct and London Paddington Station. The London Liverpool Street Station was rebuilt, opened by Queen Elizabeth II, and a new station was constructed at Stansted Airport in 1991. The following year, the Maesteg Line was reopened and the line to King's Lynn electrified. Privatisation. Rail ridership in Great Britain, 1829-2014. UK rail subsidy, 1985-2015, showing the huge increase after the Hatfield crash. Main articles: privatisation of British Rail and impact of the privatisation of British Rail between 1994 and 1997. British Rail was privatised. Ownership of the track and infrastructure passed to Railtrack on 1 April 1994. Passenger operations were later franchised to 25 private sector operators, and the freight services were sold to six companies, five of whom were owned by the same buyer. The Waterloo and City Line was part of Network Southeast. The Waterloo and City Line, part of BR Network Southeast, was not included in the privatisation and was transferred to London Underground in December 1994. The remaining obligations of British Rail were transferred to BRB Residuary Limited. The privatisation, proposed by the Conservative government in 1992, was opposed by the Labour Party and the rail unions, although Labour initially proposed to reverse privatisation. The New Labour Manifesto of 1997 instead opposed Conservative plans to privatise. The London Underground rail unions have historically opposed privatisation, but former Associated Society of Locomotive Engineers and Firemen General Secretary Lou Adams moved to work for Virgin Trains, and said on a 2004 radio phone-in programme, "All the time it was in the public sector, all we got were cuts, 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 and today there are more members in the trade union, more train drivers, and more trains running morning the reality is that it worked, we've protected jobs, and we got more jobs. Accidents and incidents. Main article, list of accidents on British Rail Network. Crowds on a rail tour at Maesteg Castle Street Station since reopened by BR as the Maesteg Line, the former BR network, with the trunk routes of the West Coast Main Line, East Coast Main Line, Great Western Main Line and Midland Main Line, remains mostly unchanged since privatisation. Several lines have reopened and more are proposed, particularly in Scotland and Wales, where the control of railway passenger services is devolved from central government. However, in England, passenger trains have returned to Mansfield, Corby, Chandler's Ford, the reopened line to Aylesbury Vale Parkway, and there are numerous other proposals to restore services, such as Oxford Milton Keynes, Aylesbury, Lewes Uckfield, Bristol Portishead and Plymouth Tavistock in London, Tyne and Wear, Greater Manchester, the West Midlands and Nottingham Urban Light Rail systems have taken over the routes of some former BR routes in Wales. The Welsh Assembly government successfully supported the reopening to passenger services of the Vale of Glamorgan line between Barry and Bridgend in 2005. In 2008, the EBBW Valley Railway reopened between EBBW Vale Parkway and Cardiff, with services to Newport scheduled to commence by 2011. The Barry Bridgend End route was included in the closures proposed in the Beeching Report of March 1963, and its services were duly withdrawn in June 1964, but EBBW Vale had already been closed to passengers before the report was published in Scotland. The Scottish government have reinstated the lines between Hamilton and Larkhall, Stirling and Alloa, and Airdrie to Bathgate. The biggest line reinstatement project was the rebuilding of part of the former Waverley route from Edinburgh to Carlisle, as the Borders Railway preserved railway lines on its creation. British Railways included the narrow gauge Vale of Rheidol Railway in Wales. Although built as a working railway, this line was by that time already principally a tourist asset. British Rail continued to operate the line, using steam locomotives, well beyond the withdrawal of standard gauge steam. The line's three steam locomotives became the only steam engines to receive top serial numbers, and the only steam engines to be painted in BR Rail blue livery, and to carry the double arrow logo. The Vale of Rheidol Railway was privatised in 1989 and continues to operate as a private heritage railway. Other preserved lines, or heritage railways, have reopened some lines previously closed by British Rail. These range from picturesque rural branch lines like the Keighley and Worth Valley Railway to sections of mainline such as the Great Central Railway. Many have links to the National Rail Network, both station interchange, for example the Severn Valley Railway between Kidderminster and Kidderminster Town, and physical rail connections like the Watercress line at Alton. Although most are operated solely as leisure amenities, some also provide educational resources, and a few have ambitions to restore commercial services over routes abandoned by the nationalised industry. Marine Services Ships. Main article, British Railways Ships. Sea Link House Flag. British Railways operated ships from its formation in 1948 on several routes. Many ships were acquired on nationalisation, and others were built for operation by British Railways or its later subsidiary, SeaLink. Those ships capable of carrying rail vehicles were classed under TOPS as Class 99 SeaLink MV Street, David berthed in Larne Hovercraft. Main article, SeaSpeed. The joint hovercraft services of British Rail under British Rail Hovercraft Limited in association with the French SNCF. British Rail Hovercraft Limited was established in 1965, under authority given to it by the British Railways Act 1967, and started its first service in 1966. SeaSpeed started cross-channel services from Dover, England to Calais and Boulogne-sur-Mer, France using Senior N4 hovercraft in August 1968. Advanced passenger train. Main article, advanced passenger train. An APT departs Euston for Glasgow. The advanced passenger train APT was an experimental tilting high-speed train developed by British Rail during the 1970s and early 1980s, for use on the West Coast Main Line, which contained a lot of curves. Notable among numerous technical advancements was the active tilting system, which the APT pioneered and has since appeared on other designs around the world. Successor companies. See also, History of Rail Transport in Great Britain 1995 to date, Privatisation of British Rail, and Impact of the Privatisation of British Rail. A first North Western Class 156 at Romilly Junction Station, near Manchester in 2001. It is in its former Regional Railways livery under the process of British Rail's privatisation. Operations were split into more than 100 companies. The ownership and operation of the infrastructure of the railway system was taken over by Railtrack. The telecoms infrastructure infrastructure and British Rail Telecommunications was sold to Racal, which in turn was sold to Global Crossing and merged with Thales Group. The rolling stock was transferred to three private Roscoe's rolling stock companies. Passenger services were divided into 25 operating companies, which were let on a franchise basis for a set period, whilst goods services were sold off completely. Dozens of smaller engineering and maintenance companies were also created and sold off. British Rail's passenger services came to an end upon the franchising of ScotRail. The final train that the company operated was a rail freight distribution goods train in autumn 1997. The British Railways Board continued in existence as a corporation until early 2001, when it was replaced with the Strategic Rail Authority. Since privatisation, the structure of the rail industry and number of companies has changed several times as franchises have been re-let and the areas covered by franchises restructured. Franchise-based companies that took over passenger rail services include Midland Mainline, superseded in 2007 by East Midlands Trains; Great North Eastern Railway, superseded in 2007 by National Express East Coast, which has since been brought back full circle into public ownership with the creation of the new government-controlled East Coast operator. The East Coast franchise was transferred to Virgin Trains East Coast on 1 March 2015. Virgin Trains West Coast, Virgin Cross Country, superseded in 2007 by cross-country ScotRail operated by National Express, superseded in 2004 by First ScotRail. Control of the franchise has since passed to Abellio ScotRail Great Western Trains. From 1998, First Great Western renamed in 2015 as Great Western Railway Wales. Transpennine Express and Northern Rail Anglia Railways, Great Eastern later First Great Eastern, and the West Anglia section of WAGN were all merged to become one later renamed National Express East Anglia, superseded in 2012 by Abellio Greater Anglia. Thameslink and Great Northern section of WAGN grouped together to form First Capital Connect as part of the Thameslink Great Northern franchise. LTS later renamed C2C Connex. Southeastern became Southeastern Trains, then Southeastern Connex. South Central became South Central and later renamed Southern. Merseyrail Electric superseded by Arriva Trains Merseyside and now Merseyrail. South West Trains Central Trains, divided in 2007 between London Midland, Cross Country and East Midlands Trains London Underground for the short underground Waterloo. Most notably, bring back British Rail. Various interested parties also have views on the privatisation of British Rail. The renationalisation of the railways of Britain continue to have popular support. A poll in 2012 showed 70% support for renationalisation due to rail franchises lasting sometimes over a decade. Full renationalisation would take years unless compensation was paid to terminate contracts early. The leader of the Green Party, Caroline Lucas, has submitted a private member's bill calling for individual franchises, when they expire or when a company fails to meet its franchise conditions, to fall back into public ownership. This will avoid expensive compensation to the rail companies when the infrastructure-owning company Railtrack ceased trading. The Labour government set up a not-for-dividend company Network Rail to take over the duties rather than renationalise this part of the network. However, on 1 September 2014, Network Rail was reclassified as a central government body, adding around £34 billion to public sector net debt. This reclassification had been requested by the Office for Budget Responsibility to comply with Pan-European Accounting Standard ESA 10 parodies in 1989. The ITV sketch show Spitting Image made a parody of Hudson's British Rail advert on the plans of the Conservative British government to privatise the railways, featuring numerous of the show's puppets, including the show's portrayal of former Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher, numerous BR trains and landmarks, and even a cardboard cutout of Thomas the Tank Engine in the 1990 film Die Hard 2. Just before the financial Windsor Air Flight 114 crashes into the runway, a stewardess can be heard remarking, "Oh, hey, we're just like British Rail, love, we may be late but we get you there." See also UK Railways Portal History. History of rail transport in Great Britain. Privatisation of British Rail. Impact of the privatisation of British Rail. Divisions, brands and liveries. C-Link BRC Division. British Rail Telecommunications. British Rail brand names. British Rail Corporate Liveries. BRB Residuary Limited. List of companies operating trains in the United Kingdom. Classification and numbering schemes. British carriage and wagon numbering and classification. British rail locomotive and multiple unit numbering and classification. Rolling stock. List of British rail classes. Steam locomotives of British Railways. List of British Railways steam locomotives as of 31 December 1967. Metros. London Underground, Glasgow Subway, Tyne and Wear Metro, Liverpool Overhead Railway. Other British Transport Police. Jerry Fines. British Rail Flying Saucer. British Rail Sandwich. The Wrong Kind of Snow. Rail Europe, Inc. Deutsche Bahn. Nederlandse Spoorwegen. SNCF. Keolis. References. Jackson, Tanya. 2013. 6. In Search of an Identity. British Railways, The Nation's Railway. Stroud, The History Press. ISBN. Carrot. The State and the Railways. Parliamentary Debates. Hansard. Hansard. 3 August 1920. Call. Carrot. Back to Beeching, BBC Radio 4, 27 February 2010. Carrot. British Transport Commission. 1963. The Reshaping of British Railways, Part 1, Report. The Railways Archive. Originally published by Her Majesty's Stationery Office. Retrieved 25 November 2006. Series. Measuringworth. Carrot. The UK Department for Transport. DFT, specifically Table 61 from Transport Statistics. Great Britain. 2006. Archived 8 September 2008 at the Wayback Machine. 4 MB PDF file. Carrot. Marsden, Colin J. 1983. British Rail. 1983. Motive Power. Combined Volume. London, Ian Allen. ISBN. The original on 20 December 2015. Retrieved 20 December 2015. Carrot. The Fall and Rise of Britain's Railways. Rail Staff News. 19 December 2013. Retrieved 11 November 2016. Carrot. Waverley Rail Project Route. History. 1955 Modernization Plan. Beeching cuts privatisation of British Rail. Accidents Legislation. Transport Act 1947. Transport Act 1962. Railways Act 1993. Transport Act 2000. Management. British Transport Commission. British Railways Board. BRB Residuary Limited. Regions. Eastern London. Midland. North Eastern. Scottish. Southern. Western. Services, sectors and subsidiaries. Passenger intercity network. Northwest network. Southeast regional railways. ScotRail. Freight Rail. Freight Rail Express Systems. Rail Freight Distribution. SpeedLink. Freightliner. Trainload Freight. Red Star Parcels. Other. British Rail Engineering. British Rail Research Division. British Rail Telecommunications. British Transport. Hotels. SeaLink. Travellers Fair. See also. Category. British Rail. VE National Railway Companies of Europe. List of Railway Companies. Rail Transport by Country. Railway Companies by Country. Albania. HSH. Armenia. SKZD1. Austria. AB. Azerbaijan. AD. Belarus. BZD. BC. Belgium. SNCB. NMBS. Bosnia. ZFBH2 and Z3. Rupees. Bulgaria. BEDS. Croatia. Czech Republic. CD. Denmark. DSB. Estonia. EVR. Finland. VR. France. SNCF. Georgia. State Route 1. Germany. DB. Greece. Trainos. Hungary. MAV. Ireland. EA. Italy. FS. Kazakhstan. CATES 1. Kosovo. HK, KS4. Latvia. LDZ. Lithuania. LG. Luxembourg. CFL. Macedonia. EMS. Moldova. CFM. Montenegro. ZPCG. Netherlands. NS. Norway. NSB. Poland. PKP. Portugal. CP. Romania. CFR. Russia. ERSD 1. Serbia. Z. Slovakia. ZSK. Slovenia. Spain. RENFA. Operadora. Sweden. SJAB. Switzerland. SBB, CFF, FFS. Turkey. TCDD1. Ukraine. UZ. United Kingdom. NR5, NIR6. 1 country partly in Asia. 2 for the Federation. BH3 for SRP. SKA4 state with limited recognition. 5 for Great Britain. 6 for Northern Ireland.